I believe it's something related to a balance update of some sort, possibly, and then there's going to be some costumes in there somewhere. So make sure you guys stick around and, you know, stay tuned for that if you guys are interested in that.
Yeah, for sure. I mean, we definitely want you guys to stick around to the very end. There is, like you said, it's going to be a small update. No new characters.
We don't have all the details yet.
Nothing
we don't have
like
all
that.
The details yet. We're still working on it.
Yeah.
But there is some kind of information coming into the stream related to something coming for the game. So, guys, make sure you stick around for that. All right, we're going to be getting into it here.
Mila,
so this
Kasumi.
Is not a button check. We see Mila against Kasumi here
I'm not
in top
mad at
eight.
The pick.
No,
again,
I'm not either.
E-Man is just testing people out with this Mila.
Again, he's going to struggle slightly because of the speed difference. The forward punch, the jab, is going to out-prioritize him because of his character speeds. But
yeah.
He can make it happen. He just got to choose when to throw his attacks out there the right way. Nice high punch hold there by TeruRock. I think we have the name swapped. Just making sure.
Yeah, so TeruRock definitely is on the left.
Yeah.
E-Man is definitely on the right.
All right, so there's that tackle. He's going to be able to get it. Nice. He gets the throw. A lot easier to input than the punches. The throw has a lot smaller window there.
For sure.
Nice. Again, man, TeruRock is not afraid to sweep you. And
I
think that in his mind, what he's doing is he knows that people block those sweeps, so he's going to keep doing it. He wants to make you block. Think about the risk-reward.
Yeah.
If you get that sweep to hit, you're putting your opponent into a 50-50. Am I going to throw you up in the air? Am I going to hit you with a mid? You're putting him into a complete 50-50 at that point.
Yep. And look at TeruRock. He is, like, at this – oh, big kind. Nice, nice, nice. TeruRock getting that good damage. Could have finished it off, but chose not to.
All right, there's that up forward kick. He's going to get the machine gun punches. What's he going to do?
Yeah.
Nice.
Nice
wow.
hold from TeruRock.
That was a great hold from TeruRock to close
two
the
Two straight
out
clean
there.
Rounds from TeruRock here.
Yeah. I think if we see E-Man struggle this hard with Mila the first game, he's gonna scare the team.
For sure. And E-Man taking that round there, you know what's really interesting about E-Man in this situation is if he can slow down the pace of this game a little bit and start recognizing when TeruRock's going to throw out those lows, he can take this pretty clean. But it's going to be, like, again, pacing right there. Nice stun and then a high counter throw. Ooh, nice, nice. TeruRock going for that raw read of a throw on wake up. And we saw that against Hoodless. Hoodless started catching on and started, you know, punishing TeruRock.
Right.
I think it's a dead character, though.
Oh, yeah, he's going to use the meteors with him. And you've seen him slightly position himself to make sure he gets the wall right there.
Yeah.
So smart. All right, let me move on again. It's going to be
1-1
to nothing in the set.
3-1, 3-1.
All right, so I think, you know, I mean, he didn't do bad with Mila, but I think that he should probably switch up to another character. Again, we're most likely going to see a Helena or a Christy in this matchup. I think Christy is the way to go, and again, we are going to see Christy coming up. He's going to be able to match TeruRock's speed. TeruRock likes to play in your face with Kasumi, so it's going to be able to help him out being able to know that he's got the 9-frame jab. He's got the 11-frame mid to be able to fight back.
Definitely, definitely, definitely.
All right, so here we go to the top of the Chinese Festival stage. Let's see who's going to bounce off the floor first.
For sure.
And we already seen what Kasumi can do on the stage. I want to know what Christy can do on the stage.
Yeah, no doubt, no doubt. And number one, we're already seeing a difference in the start of the match because he switched to Christy.
Ooh, he went off axis. He didn't want that to happen. That
Definitely
was crazy.
Not.
He catches him trying to sidestep.
Ooh, and TeruRock threw out a parry. Didn't quite get what he was looking for. Ooh, nice. And that's one thing I've seen from TeruRock that's unique to his particular Kasumi. He uses AP a lot. It's safe. It jumps over lows.
Hit.
And I'm not sure why that whiffed. But
and you've seen TeruRock's face when that combo whiffed. He was like, what happened?
What is going
that
on?
That was the second time his move went off axis in one round.
Yeah. I mean, that's Kasumi for you.
All right, here we go. Shade trying to get buffs. All right, here it is. He's going to get
that. Sometimes.
Nice. Okay, there's that size of kick. He wants that citizen assist.
Yeah, no doubt.
A whole bar to get it.
Ooh, nice fake out for E-Man there. Continuous combo.
Oh, my God.
Big
damage.
Time damage. High counter damage.
There's the jab to check him. He's going to get the boxes. Oh, wait. There's
quite. There's no boxes.
No, he didn't get the boxes. He landed right in between those boxes, too.
Yeah,
What a lucky guy.
The difference in pacing from this match is different than the last game because both these characters are, like, you know, the fastest in the world. And right now, nice break hold. TeruRock needed that. Oh, great throw break. And E-Man, I like the option here. Are we going to get the – no, he's on the edge.
Yeah, he's right on the edge.
It's weird. I think characters have different properties of moves because, you know, some characters can take advantage of the edge.
And honestly, I don't know there's something with it that I don't understand yet. I've tried to test it. Sometimes it works, sometimes it doesn't. I don't understand.
But what is working is that box and into the off off the stage. Oh, he doesn't get it. Doesn't recognize it.
He's right off. Wow.
E-Man not willing to hold there. And the stage right there messed him up. And TeruRock just yelled out. He's like, why is another combo dropping? And again, it's because the stage throws off Kasumi's combos. It is what it is. Nice throw break from E-Man.
Wow.
Nice throw again from E-Man. TeruRock in trouble. On game point, E-Man takes it. He's on the board. TeruRock 1-1. TeruRock taking his headset off, reeling a little bit in his seat, just wondering why are these combos dropping
so
on these uneven stages.
Emotional. Especially TeruRock, you know, and I never noticed it before, but TeruRock is a very emotional player.
Yeah,
and he's shaking his head because he's like. Because
it's frustrating. It's a frustrating thing to see. There's no question.
People don't understand how significant one combo drop is. Think about it. If you drop a combo, not only are you missing the damage from that combo, the positioning of what you could have been is completely thrown off.
Yeah.
You're now behind someone and you should have been in front of them. You're now away from the box and you should have been near it.
For sure.
Everything comes into account there. That's why I can't stand when that happens.
Yeah, but you know what's interesting is that is probably the most emotion we've seen from TeruRock in any tournament here in the U.S.
Wow, okay, he's going to get the roof there. Oh, I see what it is. Yeah. It's literally a corner of the roof.
It's literally a corner.
That's what it is. Okay, now we're under a roof. We're under an actual roof now.
Great break from E-Man there. And what a sidestep. Nice duck from TeruRock. Great recognizing the string. And again, he's trying to get some space on E-Man. Different little strategy than what we saw in the previous game. Nice hold.
Nice hold. He needed that to stop the pressure.
And I think that's what it is. He doesn't want to get caught into the vortex of Christie pressure.
Yeah.
He's trying to get away from it, get
if
some space.
If you can stop her before she gets started, you
nice
need
defense.
To do it.
Defense. TeruRock just kind of sitting on the ground.
Wow. There's that DOA6 ground game there.
And again, this change in pace is very smart from TeruRock. He recognizes the fact that he can do this because the stage's corridors are basically forever long. And it allows him to do that.
Okay, so TeruRock, again, he's so good at positioning himself. We just saw him free step slightly just to get that stun.
Gets that free damage. Big time damage coming up. I like it. I like
both
the
setup. Players so smart with how they're using the meter. All top eight, we've seen really, really great meter management. They've gotten so much better with over time.
E-Man.
Wow, that was
recognized
so
TeruRock didn't want to actually press any buttons. TeruRock, nice use of the 4P. Such a rare move from Kasumi players.
Is he going to send him out of the window? Steps. He's not. He just misses the window. All he needs is one hit to make this comeback. Look at the movement.
TeruRock just getting that space again.
Wow,
smart play from
E-Man. Because that was a dead string. No matter what, down HSK would have worked regardless if he canceled it or did it right away. He tried to delay it, but E-Man recognized the string, went under with the down HSK.
And it's interesting because TeruRock throughout this tournament has actually been using the kick in the mid-kick ender, delaying that, and that would have worked, but he switched it up.
Yeah.
And it cost him the round. It's going to cost him another round here. It's a great for E-Man.
Right. All right, so E-Man taking another round again. This is first to three in top eight here at Summer Jam. Gets the frame advantage. No buttons from TeruRock. Wow.
That is one of my favorite attacks in this game. It's
really
so
good.
Fast.
It tracks and it's plus in this game now.
It's really, really strong. Nice launcher from TeruRock. He needs his damage. He should take advantage of that window. Yep. Good damage. Takes him down to about 50%. TeruRock trying to challenge a wake-up kick with 6P.
Is he going
to
use it?
Not sure he wants to do that.
He's going to save it. All right. What's the setup? Four punch to open him up, and this could be bad. He's got to use, and he's
dead.
That's
dead character.
Wow.
And it started with the challenging of that wake-up kick. When you're a Kasumi player, 6P cannot beat either option. TeruRock's going to have to remember that going into the next game.
You're going to have to use something that prioritizes in damage, and obviously the forward punch is not going to beat a wake-up kick. So we're going to possibly end it off here if TeruRock cannot make a comeback. It seems like he's out of steam.
Yeah. Yeah, I mean, the frustration from those drop combos in game two really looked like they took a toll on him mentally.
Right.
He's got to bounce back.
But trust me, E-Man is the last guy you want to be out of steam against because
for
he
sure.
can do this all day.
And E-Man wakes up and punishes that Kasumi whiff with a throw.
Right.
It's one of those situations that Kasumi players don't like to admit because she's at disadvantage when that particular punch whiffs.
Yeah.
So it's basically almost a free throw. Not quite, but it puts her in a really bad spot.
Right. Wow, the delay on the string. E-Man working that jab string so
nice
well.
Break
There's
hold.
The break hold.
E-Man not willing to give up a round. This is a guaranteed situation. And oh my gosh.
Again, I keep telling
ankles,
you.
Ankles. Watch those ankles.
TeruRock. He wants to switch his name to Ankle Rock. He's literally just attacking everybody's legs.
It's
and they're not blocking.
not. Watch your
feet.
Right, watch
his back. What's the mix up? There's the frame advantage. Hits a button this time.
Oh, nice delay. Beats out the break hold. Safe. And good defense from E-Man. You can only do that string so many times before he's going to recognize and punish it accordingly. Nice break.
Wow, and there's the serpent step. What's he going to do?
And not challenging the kick there. doesn't need to. Looks like he's going to close his round out on the board with his own round. E-Man sitting at 1-1 with TeruRock.
Again, E-Man is literally two rounds away from eliminating this man from
the tournament.
Nice hold again. Beautiful low kick hold, though. He needed that.
Half life. Great reads from TeruRock so far in round three.
Wow, took his back.
Yeah.
Oh, man, this is not good. What's he going to do? And he took his back.
Oh.
And that's
big time.
I think that's going to do for the round if he used the meter. He's
going
to use it. He wants to. There you go. Again, sometimes, guys, you got to use that meter. Now, look. He has none.
Wow.
He has no sidesteps, but think about it.
Wow.
He has
a
special sidestep. He doesn't need meter to step.
Yeah.
Remember that.
Yeah.
All right. There it is. 3-3-P into the bound. Quarter circle forward punch. Gets the close hit damage.
TeruRock. Nice use of 3K there. TeruRock whipping a lot of holds right now. Uses some meter to reset the situation.
Wow.
Run up and throw. High counter damage. Counter strike. Caught TeruRock pressing another button in between his string delays there.
There's that up kick there. And again, we just talked about them fixing that.
Yeah.
That would have whiffed.
TeruRock trying to check E-Man with mid punches right now.
Okay, delays the string. That's safe. Wow, did you see him? He just ran in his face.
Yeah. And TeruRock sitting on full meter.
Oh, man, he opened them up. He's dead.
Dead.
And just like that, with the forward grab to close the game out.
Big mistake.
TeruRock will be eliminated from the tournament. E-Man will be moving on in the tournament.
Yikes. Big mistake.
Wow. Really great game, though. I mean, you know, TeruRock has done a great job, and he's very